What's up, dudes? Today's Wednesday. Got my pops with me. Think we're gonna cruise on a trail. Probably be at a much slower, lower pace today, just cruising around, having fun. It's very much cooler today than it was the other day, yesterday. Yesterday it was 88, today it's 66. Much cooler. Funny how the temperature and weather can change so much from one day to the next. Poor old man's gonna be back there eating dust like crazy. See if we can get out of all this dusty stuff and get over into the real trail. This stuff is just like powdered moon dust, man. Pretty bad. On these first couple trails, anyway. Pretty fun week of riding, dude. Lord willing. Rode yesterday just for fun, which was Wednesday or Tuesday. Today is Wednesday. Out riding with Dad. Man, this hill keeps getting more and more dug in. I don't know who's digging that in, but woo!
Man. It's a dandy right at the top.
Anyhow, gonna be a heck of a good week riding around here. Thursday, tomorrow, gonna go meet up with Rusty Kane and go ride McCubbins a little bit. If it's as nice and cool tomorrow as it is today, then it should be pretty awesome. This hill climb comes up at. I've never seen where it comes up out of here onto the trail. I don't think it does come up here. Where the hell does that hill climb come up? That hill climb never comes up?
Oh yeah, you missed it.
I was looking the whole way up the hill.
I know, and it's a right at that rocky spot. It's a bad spot right on the where it comes up and over.
Huh, I didn't see it.
I think they're leaving the ground when they're coming up.
I bet so.
Yeah.
didn't even see where they were coming up over that.
Yeah.
Trail one done. Yeehaw! You wanna lead? That matters.
Here we go, man.
What? Oh, I didn't know you worry about it. I've been watching it ain't too dusty. Have at her, I'll follow you. It's pretty tight. It's kind of dusty, but it's so moist in here, and underneath the trees it's so good that it won't be too bad. Unless the old man gets too excited. If he gets too excited, then it'll get dusty. Talking about riding through the woods with my pop. Pretty awesome. Super stoked that he can still come out and ride it all with his hands. He's got really bad arthritis. Him and my grandma Bull, really bad arthritis. Grandma got to where she was having a hard time like picking up coffee cups. Her grip strength was getting down so bad. Dad still does pretty good. He hates it at the end of the day if he's got to swing a hammer all day, I'll tell you that much. But for the most part, he does okay. For a small little amount. I wouldn't ask him to come ride a hare scramble distance race with me or nothing. We did that 20 miles the other day for the poker run, and he said that was okay. Didn't hurt him too bad, so. Gentle pace out around the woods. So far I've been pretty lucky and I don't have any signs of arthritis yet. So I'm hoping that I don't get it. It's possible that I could, both my grandma and my dad. And I believe my grandpa did too, but he passed away from cancer before he ever got old enough to have the arthritis become a problem. Or a big problem, I should say. Some of these trees that I think are tight, he thinks are really tight. Yeah, it might get close to my bark busters and my handlebars, but it gets really close to his tires. Fenders, feet. Today is a more laid-back ride, a more just fun in the woods, and kind of a slower trip through the woods. To me, this is good fun, and part of the reason why I love coming and doing this stuff. Part of the reason I used to ride and learn to ride was my dad in the first place. We used to set up little tracks wherever we stopped to ride the three-wheeler or the dirt bike and see how fast we could go through them and how fast we could get. Take turns back and forth doing it. He's pretty much the one that instilled the love of off-roading and racing, period. Just going fast, trying to push yourself to go fast all the time I grew up. So I get it all from him. Back in his day, he was ripping around on dirt bikes just like I am. kinds of different reasons and stuff to get out here in the woods and check out the forest, check out places you ain't been before or ain't been in a while. He wants to cruise down here and see the gate, I guess. Where do you think you're going? What's that?
The other way right up here?
No, it's up this gravel road that way.
Oh, yes, right. That's right.
Which, whatever, I've never ridden this. I have no idea what road this even is.
It's the one that dead ends. The one of Bo, just one of Bo's, where Brian camped. But there's one more than the park. When I came back off of there, somehow I got on this road and drove down to here, and he's like,
What the fuck did you do? Part of the club, I'm tired.
anyway, he's gonna get about it.
Yeah, I did the same thing on that one trail where you kind of go down that side hill and you're going down on the side hill and the valley's your side. And then when you get to the bottom, you hit that gravel road.
Yep.
And we always turn and go left because it says no OHV that way. Well, I drove up to that. Up to the end of that the other day to that intersection, and it intersects to another big old gravel road. But what gravel road it is, I got no fucking idea. And the one that goes down into the hill doesn't look well traveled at all, you know, because it hits the four-wheel drive road there eventually. But the one it tees into, it looks fucking well traveled, like this, like a main gravel road. And it's like, well, how the fuck? There's so many roads up here, I don't know where the hell they go. But
I was looking at the map, and it kind of makes a wow.
Yeah, the main, this one probably goes to the campground. So we're going to go up the gravel road, and then it loops to the right and hits that campground. And this one probably goes straight up this way and hits that campground.
Yeah, it does. 923 and 925.
I didn't start my tracker, but it should be tracking where we're at. I'm pretty sure this is the road that leads to that campground.
It could.
Yep, it is. So see, this is the way we normally go up this old gravel road, and it loops around, and then you hit right there is the campsite. Well, if we just drive up this gravel road, this is that main one that I said went right past it, and then go left, that's going to be it.
We'll miss all that bullshit.
4840 is what it says this road is.
We're
off the 921.
1841. This is where we came off of here. We've hit this gravel road right here. We need to turn this gravel road right here. We need to turn and head right back up to the other gravel.
Yeah, so the 4841, if I zoom out far enough, it calls that this the 4841 also.
Okay.
It says 4840 here, but 4841 up there, so. So maybe it is just a dead end if we take this. It just dead ends right there. And then, yeah, we're going to go down. So this must be the campground.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, because that's right where it comes off and you turn back and that's that campground. Yep.
Yeah. 923 to 925.
Yeah, because it is a little bit further through here to that campground than I think it is. Every time I get here, I'm like, oh, I'm close to the campground. Well, not quite.
Especially the way the trails go.
Yeah.
They're fucking zigzagging and fucking 4 to 5 miles.
But yeah, we'll cruise back over here and jump on the gravel. Perfect. some of these rocks I can get through pretty easy because I'm a dirt bike, but boy, the old man, he just pretty much has to fucking smash through all this shit. Try and get four tires and go through it all good. Slippy. Which I could probably get away without even slipping it if I just kept it going faster, but trying not to go faster. Hang out and actually ride with my dad, not just leave him. Some of this stuff's a lot more challenging in the four-wheeler. Those don't want to break! I've ridden by this so many fucking times and wanted to know who the fuck and what the fuck is going on down here.
Yeah.
Is it an actual trail or did someone just go too fast and lose it? I think it's an actual trail. I don't know where the fuck it goes, but it's a trail of some type.
It keeps going, huh?
Yeah, it keeps going clear out of sight.
Well, the
definitely a dirt bike
on,
only trail.
Like, well, they'd have had to come out if they couldn't go no further.
Well, I tried looking down below to see if it ever ties back in, and I never can see it, but then again, I couldn't see where the other one tied in on the hill climb. So, yeah, this one, the first couple times, I thought it was people overshooting this corner.
Yeah.
I thought they just missed it, and then pretty soon I was looking down there going, I think it's a fucking trail. So many hidden little trails that I have no idea about.
Well, that's like back up there where that spring was. Do you see the water up the side?
Spring.
There is fucking columns.
I didn't see no spring.
I'll be going to hell.
Before the campsite? After?
Before.
Way before.
Must be just on the flats then.
Yeah. All
right.
I don't have it on.
Yeah, it's recording and everything. Oh. Red light blinking and everything.
I turned the light back on.
Okay.
Okay. Good deal.
But no, I didn't see any water or anything. Normally up here, there's no springs that come across the trail anywhere or nothing.
I caught it.
And it's.
Yeah. I've been through there before, above it, and I knew it was swampy, but I've never seen the waller.
Awesome. I'm sure the other day riding up towards, more towards Badger Road, fuck a pile of bear poop. It wasn't a great big pile, but pretty good sized pile of bear poop right in the middle of the fucking road. Yep. You little suckers!
See where something peed in the trail up there. Yeah, a deer or something went by.
Yeah. I just had to stop and check that out. I've ridden by it so many times, and the first couple times I could have swore it was just people missing the corner. But then it kept getting more and more defined, and I thought, fuck, that's a trail.
The more go down, they got to turn back out. So, That's what makes the trail.
I guess this time, since we're going slow and chill today, I'm going to keep my eye out on the right-hand side and see if this ever comes back in anywhere. Which I don't know. It'd have to be clear at the bottom of the canyon to do it. Oh, yeah. That's what I was thinking.
And there's good day to look at it.
Woo! Come up the other side, too. Time to shave. My beard getting itchy. Getting stuck in the helmet buckle. Deer, a mama deer and a baby deer. Dang it, not gonna get another view of them. A mama deer and a little tiny baby deer took off running. I don't think we're gonna see them again. Which, knowing the camera angle, you guys probably didn't see him in the first place. Just a flash of brown across the screen. So if that other trail comes down, it would have to come down somewhere in here, I would imagine. If it goes through. Seems like some awful steep country to me to be coming down off this hill. There it is, right there. So however it takes off of that one up there, this is where it comes to. It looks like some steep, fun stuff. Because there's almost another draw between us and the original draw.
Hey,
That's where that fucker goes.
I was looking for it.
But that's got to be a draw in between us still, right?
No.
Yeah, because we got to the bottom and then came back up, and now we're coming back down. Like, we came up over this ridge top, so it's got to be down another one and up the other side.
Yeah, you look at your fucking map, that trail's right above us right there. Swings clear up there and it comes back.
Possible, I guess.
Won't take you long, zoom up the top, come back.
Yeah, right, dude, not on this. That looks pretty fucking steep.
I like it.
It looks pretty steep. But yeah, I would love to give her a shot one day. See what's up there. Old mama and the baby probably hiding down here in the bottom of the canyon. Never to be seen again. Tiny bit of water left down in there, but it ain't flowing very good no more. Cruising, go a long ways fast on gravel, or take the slow road and weasel through the woods. Gravel, okay. Ba 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 ba. too long. Gotta give her a little bit. Hopefully I didn't drown Papa in dust and dirt and gravel on the face. Yeehaw! I had to let it eat a little bit.
Yeah.
It was getting all loaded up. So you probably already noticed, but all the manzanita and the buck brush down here, it's already bloomed and brown. Yesterday up there by Badger, it was all in beautiful white blooms and like the whole trail stank of flowers. It was amazing. And then I get down here and I see all these and they're already browned already. It's like, aww.
Yeah, mine are already done brown.
Yeah. I see still lots of white flowers, but all of the big bushes are all brown already.
Not the green grass. Not the
be a tight one for that. poor 125 is like, dude, really? Second gear, bog me down. I'm not even riding fast. You prick. And I still love it. Still pull the wheelie any old time. Yeah, you see that? Fucking had the dirt pushed up in a spot like that. Yeah, I think I seen one yesterday, but the only part I seen was white. But it had a bunch of dirt puffed up like that and just a little white edge sticking out. Yeah. Which is funny because it's fucking bone dry, dude. Like, I mean, maybe down deep it's got some moisture, but this shit's all just bone dry. How mushrooms are still coming up, I don't know. We need another good rain. Man, this little section of road right here has got so many blowdowns. I gotta pee real quick.
Here I go.
Yeehaw! We're getting close to the upper OHV, so I told Pops to take the lead and he can flow through here at whatever pace he wanted. And we'll just try and do low-speed wheelies behind him. Which is always fun. Drill.
Oh,
Yeah! Does this run to the tower? There's a bunch of different chutes.
What? Does this one go up to the tower?
Yeah. Yeah. No, not that way. Yeah, I guess it is that way. I don't remember that tree being fell. I didn't remember coming over here. No, this is the only one I know of. And it used to go through somewhere to get back across. But now it's just a dead end. You can't go anywhere from right up there.
Yeah. No.
But it used to go through. Ain't nobody ridden it in a while.
It don't look that bad.
No. If I had 20 feet to land, maybe not, but the worst part is you can't get going in those rocks either.
No.
You can't get any momentum in that cobble and then try to hit this loose ass shit with no momentum.
I wonder if they're going down or if they're actually coming up.
I don't know, down it looks just as scary as up it to me.
You pile it up in them rocks.
Well, yeah. There's no brakes, there's no slowing down. Just roll that bitch and then hope for the best. Hey, that looks like some rain over there.
There was a few spots on the ground up there where you're parked at.
There is a couple drops, like I could see it even dropping between me and the clouds. Bring us the rain, bring it!
Yep, quite the historical side here.
Yeah, I don't know what all this wood was from. If that's from the original tower that used to be up here, or yeah. What?
Yep, yeah, they dropped it. Went up in the fucking air, one of the fucking lines came loose, and down to the fucking ground, and it fucking came.
Yeah.
often, I think.
When we go back out on the way out, you can still see one of the concrete columns.
Oh yeah. Yep.
Pyramid columns sitting there.
All around on top of
there.
All the anchor fucking posts and stuff are still around.
But yeah, some of those guys that are hardcore fucking rock enthusiasts, boy, if they found out we had this canyon. Yeah, those crazy rock guys would just love that fucking flat rock and all these big slabs and balls. And I don't know how they ride over that shit, but they do.
Like a fucking bicycle. How the fuck do you bounce that fucker back and forth and back and forth?
I think it's the 300s that all of them guys are using. So it's just as light as my fucking 125, but it's got 300 cc's of power.
Yeah.
So you don't ever hit the pipe. You're always lugged down, but you got 300 cc's of grunt all the time. Because this one, when you lug it down, oh, it just, the most amazing traction, it just fucking hooks and walks fucking right goes up. Good. It just doesn't have that grunt, you know, lots of it. Yeah. But yeah, it's kind of a weaselly way to get up here. You got to go around that way and it's the only way I know how to get up here.
There's a shortcut I seen where they came up the bottom.
Yeah. Yep, just all depending on how big your berries are.
That's the only way I know too, but I could have sworn there was a trail that went off the top of that.
I don't think so, but maybe.
I went slow and didn't see any of that.
That could be an old trail. This comes out right in the corner. This is the corner that we always take, and then we finally hit the gravel road. Well, this is, if you just turn and loop back up, you go right up to the top. That's hilarious.
Yeah.
You were right. That trail goes right through. Yeah, you know, as we're coming out of the trees and you come up and take the right and then it hits the gravel road, right there, if you take the left, it comes right through to there. So instead of going down these dirt roads and everything, you could just pop right through there and...
Well, awesome. Just hasn't been used enough.
Yeah, no, it's all brushy. But it's a pretty clear road once you cut some trees out of the way. It'll do it, but boy, you gotta have confidence. Crazy. How in the heck did I get a pine needle inside my goggles? Whoop whoop!
Thank you.
trouble, Big Rock. Good. I like that little chunk of trail. Got some good hooky corners and some oh shit corners. Old man's probably cussing me for taking that trail. Kapow! Woo!
That is a nasty monster.
Oh, that fucker's fun, dude. I love it. Love it.
Want water?
Sure. That was like the weakest push start ever. Well, he ain't in the campsite at all, he's across from the campsite. Tiki Taki? Alright! Looks like the battery's pretty low though. What time is it? It's only 7. Battery shouldn't be that low. Got Dad back to his pickup truck, got him all loaded up. Drink me a big old thing of water. Back to Madras. thing is missing and skipping all kinds. The bike really is bogged down, it really is loaded up, like trying to get it to lean out and get rid of all the fucking oomph that we built up going so slow. This is the first time I've ever went slow enough that it really did build it up bad. We rode my 450 on the poker button weekend, and that thing heated up because of going slow, but it doesn't really load up or be too rich or anything, but boy, this thing, when you fucking run it slow and putt around, it don't like it. Which I don't really care, I don't really ride it that way ever, so. Riding it this time so I can ride with my dad and have a good time. Not having to go too fast or nothing, but can sure feel it in the bike. Now she's starting to liven back up and get a little more ready to go, but that first hill climb we did, man, every time I roll on the throttle, it bogged. I said before, I need to lean out that pilot just a little more. Super cool, 60 degrees or so, I would guess. Pretty friggin' cool. overcooked that one. They need to cut that out the right way. Fuck my flow all up. About it as I'm riding it. If I want to ride it any old way and build a bog it down and cut it around, then I probably need to lean it out. But when I get up here and get riding like this, aggressive, on it, it's perfect. So, makes it really hard to decide whether I want to keep it where when I'm riding hard, it rides good, but when I'm putting, because I don't putt very often. Or do I make it where it'll putt good? Because as you can hear, when I get it up and running, up the temperature and I'm on the pipe, it runs crisp. But if I put it around like I was when I was following my dad, it does load up a little bit after an extended period. It didn't take very long of riding it hard to get it to clean back up, but I think since this is just my bike and I'm not sharing it with a newer rider or a slower rider or anything, I think I'll probably leave it this way. But if I was sharing it with a slower rider, less throttled rider, then I would probably have to lean it out a little more just so when they're putting along it wouldn't load up. People tell me, well, I've had all kinds of internet people tell me all kinds of shit about my bike, but I've had some people that I think have some kind of idea how it works, whatever, have told me that I'm running too big of a main jet on it. I'm running a 168. They say that that's too big, too rich. But the funny thing is, anytime I hold this thing wide open when it's bogging out or hesitating, it immediately cleans out and runs crisp. If it was too rich and the bike bogged down, when I went full throttle, it would just bog out and die. Because it would be already be rich, loaded up, and then it would be too rich when I went wide open. But it doesn't do that. When I go wide open, it actually leans out, cleans up, and screams. So even running the big 168 jet on the main, it's by far not rich. Or too rich, I should say. Most of all the bogs I've ever had on this bike are mid-throttle or low-throttle. And And yes, I know that some of it has been me asking too much at low RPM. And I normally jiggle with my ass and then shift down when I do those things. But ouch, that branch always hurts. I still haven't cut it either. Oh well. To the bottom.
Yeah. Yeah.